Are you ready for this? I am going to show you something amazing. It's going to blow your mind. So, have you ever seen those videos that other programmers using Cursor and any other no-code programming tools and using the cloud update, which is Sonnet 3.7, and they try to make games using no-code? It is, we saw it was a pretty responsive, not that great quality, but still, that's a very, very best step for creating games. And I think I just cracked the code to using no-code, create a very high-quality game. This is a starter, actually, but still, it's going to blow your mind. Watch this. Here you go. This is one of the games that I created for a Telegram. It's a Telegram, one of those tap games that you get cryptocurrencies as a reward. This is one of them. This is what I call it, Golden Glow. And one of them is Flame of Wisdom. Let's play it and just tap on the flames. See that? See how cool it is? And this is going to be your reward, Enlightenment. Let's just come out, go to the menu. This is the top score you're gonna get, which is right now it's 232. Let's go to Path of Enlightenment. And this is how it's look. This is 2048 game, which is, I think, what it's called. And this is going to happen in the Telegram, which is when you're using it as your smartphone. So let's just come on out. Okay, so as you see, we get our 68 score. So how did I did it? So the key is we're going to use some graphical animation elements inside of our code, which is part of a lot of things you can see. So let's try something. Let's create a new folder just for a new project. Gonna say it, light simulator. We're gonna put it in ask. A lot of people do not use ask mode in Cursor. I'm encouraging you, please start using more ask, because yes, agent, it is doing it automatically, but we need to create a plan for AI to follow it. We need a roadmap for AI, and ask mode is going to create that mind map. So we're going to use a lot of those ask mode and chat with AI, and AI create a mind map for itself, and AI after that can follow that mind. That's why I'm going to say it. All right, let's say I want to create a light simulator like game. I'm gonna add web context, go for it, and scan for it in the internet. How to build it? Give me a step by step strategy. Here we go. Right now it's gonna come up with a plan for me, so how to build it for me. Now, as you can see, come up with a complete plan. It programming JavaScript, TypeScript, web, or C#, C++, desktop, engine, Three.js, web-based, Unity, yeah. Set up your development environment, install Node.js, implement aircraft physical, lift, drag, thrust, gravity. Create the world, sky, basic, train, generation, high gram. All right, would you like me, as you can see, said, would you like me to help set up basic project structure for web-based pricing in 3.js? This would be a good starting point. So I'm get rid of the web tag. Let's go to the agent right now. I'm going to say it. That's perfect. Build it for me. Here we go. So right now it's create a index.html. So it's going to be a web-based game. And you see we 3.js too. So we use mostly 3.js for controlling interactive elements. So that's what it's going to use. So before it's going to finish the game, I'm going to take all of that, all of the mind map and the roadmap that it's come up with, and I'm just going to go to, another chatbot. So let's see how we can come up with a way to use elements, 3D elements, highly realistic elements, as for our game. So let's go to Grok. I guess I'm going to need VPN, because I'm in Iran, guys, which is going to be a challenging for me. Let's just sign in x.ai. Here we go. All right, let's go to Gemini. We can use any other chatbot that has a deep research. Gemini has it, Grok has it, Perplexity has it. I use Gemini and let myself down. Let's just go say I want to build this game, but I need this game. Finger down. I need 3D graphic element like plane. How to make it or where can I download it? And how to apply it in this project? So right now, I'm going to ask it and come up with a strategy and or give me some website, anything else. So where can I download it? We can use this kind of element or we can come up with our own element. You see, let's just run the game again. As you will see in that Telegram game, I used some graphical animation. This was not using any 3D or elements. I used AI to come up with the pictures. And I use image to video feature in AI like Kling or in Minimax, and I created a loop animation. That's what I used. So just create a new windows, let's go to Golden Glow, and let's run the game again. The local path, you see that? Everything that you see in here, a little bit of lag in here. So now it just load up. As you can see in the background, we have some animations in here. In the buttons, I created animations in here based on the niche of the game. And I created a scroll effect in here. Got some effects in here. And we get a leaderboard. We have some animations a little bit down here. And this button as well. I use it, but you see this animation, it's just in the loop. I created it using AI. So let's just in there, myself down here. Let's go to the public images. Client public, and this is the end. You see that I create some web files. This is the flame of wisdom. As you can see, this is part of the background of the button. So see that? Let's just bring it up. You see, this is part of the background of the button. FOW game with WP, this is the file that I put it in the background of the flame of wisdom game. See that? When I play this, it is the game, and you see that as a background. This is part of the animation of so. And just like any idea, anything else in the game, I use WebP file. But this is kind of a heavy game, and you need a lot of coding for graphical optimization. So the graphic would not come down. It would be as lightweight as possible and smooth in playing. So it's not easy to use the WebP file. Just think about it. Even the GIF file, all of that is going to cost you a lot of time and headaches, because this is one of the projects I work on. It took me more than a month to finish it. Yeah, more than a month because of the graphics. And the person who wants this game just wanted to be like that, and because of my lack of knowledge of it, it took me a lot of time. So what is the solution? That's why I'm going to use Gemini to come up with it. See, integrated in 3 airplane mode into a 3.js flights. Okay, platform sketchfab, CG trader, Turbo Squid, free and paid option. Let's search for sketchfab. Let's just close those, and this one as well, close the server. All right, the leading platform for 3D and AI on the web. Join the millions of 3D creators in a showcase. Not bad. The most powerful 3D editor online. So buy 3D models for business. Explore. Let's see if there is a cars and vehicle. Let's go to that first of all and see what are the things that it had. So all these 3D ones. Plane. Yeah, we can use those. Yeah, this one's go good with the navy one. Let's see, does it have any other? Oh, F-47. Any other one? So let's just go with the navy because it's a little bit more close to the modern plane. Can we download it? Really want to use it for free. So aircraft. Can we download? Does it have? Yeah, embedded. So this is all the good, great element for game guy. Perfect. Let's go for the FedEx or yeah, this one I like. Yeah. Can we download? Download tree model, let's log in, agree, no I don't want upload tree model, sharing, purchase or download, ok, game dev. Let's go for it. I have to go back to find model Lion. This model is okay. Let's go to the ask again. We don't have any code base. We already use the code base defaults in the new update of the cursor. We don't need to add code base tag. All right, let's just say that I have a 3D model for the plane. Which format the best to use? I'm gonna take all of it. Yeah, let's just add web as well. For your flight simulator, JLB is the best one to use for your plane model. JLB is the binary version that is highly recommended for 3.js project for several reasons. It's specifically designed for the web-based design, 3D render, okay? So just gonna get for the JLB. So which one? 1 meg texture, 2K. Yeah, I'm gonna already download it. It's downloaded right now. Pretty small size. All right, JBL. So I'm gonna add, where should I put 3D model file? And what should I name it? Aircraft and aircraft, say done. I'm gonna put it in agent. Let's say done. Make sure gonna show in the game. Let me, as you can see, for every element, it's like for every element, we're gonna use a JS file. We're gonna create a JS file for every element in any game. For trees, for cars, for characters, for planes. In this particular project, this is how it's going to use in online. So great, the JF loader is already included in your HTML file. Now let's update the main.js. Yeah, to correctly expose the camera to the sky component and make sure the aircraft model is probably initial. Yes, yeah, it's done. Debug, let's check for any errors for the loader in the browser console. You need to run a local website. Perfect setup. Perfect. Sky to flight control. Yep, run this game. The flight simulator. Python. We already used Python. Python was not found. I already installed it. Node. Yeah, we already have npx. Y. Here we go. So available. Let's go with which one. So how? I don't know how to run this one. Go. Route when I run local link. Of course. All right. Loading flights. Okay. So it's all black. Let's see the plane and one way and sky. Make sure the plane is in third person angle cam. So let's just run again. It was in, yeah, we just F5, refresh it, just already gone. So there was a glimpse of the plane that just come up in the simulator. So that's actually a win. And that means the GLB file is actually reading the file and we can use it in the game. So what we saw was nothing. It means there was no runway, there is no sky, nothing. So what I thought is it might be in the first person angle. We have to put the plane in the third person because we want to see a plane in the back. You saw in the games, when the plane is gonna maneuver, our camera in the third person angle is move with it. See, that's what we want to do. And that's what we have to say it to the AI as what the term is, the third person angle camera. So that's why I said it. Now just let it apply all these changes and we see what it's going to change. Because this is going to revolutionize the gaming. We do not need big industry and big companies to create game for us. We can create our own game. We don't need to just tell the cursor to create a game. The cursor just create all the elements and all the spots for the animation and the graphics to take place. And we're just going to put all those animation and graphic files in those places. That's it. So this is going to help us a lot fast. All right. Let's just go into this flight simulator, come up, press C to toggle the camera view. So see, there was this one. Yeah, see the glimpse of this, still just go to the black, see if there is now it should run. Yeah, but still in the game all I see is black screen only for a moment, playing deeply fade and fade, say here. Spell disappear. All right, All right, don't judge me, all right? It's been a long time I haven't been spoken English. I think it's been a year. My last video about English language is about, but no code. But I'm mostly speaking Persian because I'm in Iran, which is, you already hear all of the news about conflict between Iran and I'm not trying to think about it, and I'm just trying to immigrate from this. So I see no code as a perfect opportunity. So I think Lord Jesus Christ has just blessed me with it and opened all the doors for me and say, son, just come on, everything is okay now. So that's, I feel perfectly okay. I'm just feel fine at this present. Yeah, crowd.js. I'll fix the black screen issue where the disappearing. Now let's check if there's any other issue physically to JS file that causing. And guys, if you want any of these files to use it on your own project, I put all of the links down below. Just go for it and click on it. And don't forget to subscribe. So yeah, thank you. Okay, let's run it again. Ooh, debug. Here we go. See that? This is the right, especially the very, very bad angle. I don't know. I have fun. I'm having fun. Not bad at all. I don't know where I'm. Ooh, where is the sky? Oh, here we go. So not bad. I'm gonna take a screenshot. I'm gonna say, here we go. I'm gonna paste it in here. I see the front side as third. I need to see the back of the plane. Fix it. Still like how it messed up the game, but still it was fun. Fix this. So you the back of the plane, yeah, instead of the front, the third person view. So it was the external new vector minus. So it was it has to be minus. Change the external camera offset to see how it was on the project. I'm gonna do that the same here. Here we go later. Still seeing the front. Whoa! So control WS, pitch D, and shift crawl camera reset. So we set the R, it's gonna reset. Now it's gonna come into the front. See, at least the physics is better. Not bad. So I'm gonna end it in here. I'm gonna see what can I do for the next video. I'm gonna see how it's gonna go. Toggle debug, yeah. Alright, so this is how we can come up with a game like that. This is how I go, and I like that. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I see you in the next video. Goodbye, everybody. Bye-bye.